remembering Bishop Ross on today and for his legacy and for his foundation. And then he passed the mantle on to our pastor, Pastor Dale Lee Tucker Sr. And so, God, we thank you for what he's brought to our church and how he continues on with the vision of the church. And so we're just very thankful and grateful. And I don't know about you, but I'm just glad to be in the sanctuary on today. It's okay to stream and all of that kind of stuff, but it's something about being in the sanctuary. So I praise God today. And for you that are streaming on today, we ask that you would celebrate us on today. When Jesus came into the coast of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, saying, "Whom do men say that I, the Son of Man, am?" And they answered and said, "Some say thou art John the Baptist, some Elias, and others Jeremiah, or one of the prophets." He said unto them, "But whom say ye that I am?" And Simon Peter answered and said, "Thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God." And he answered and said unto them, "Blessed are thy Salmon Barjona, for flesh and blood did not reveal it unto thee, but my Father which is in heaven. And I say unto thee that thou art Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. And I will give unto thee the keys of the kingdom of heaven. And whatsoever thou bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. And whatsoever thou loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven." And the word of the Lord is blessed.
Just how much we
the day that you have made. And God, we will rejoice and be glad in it. God, we thank you for last night's lying down and this morning's early rise. God, we thank you that you made the enemy behave. When we got up, everything was in the right place. And for that, God, we say thank you. God, you got us in our cars and we rode over the highways and through the streets, and you made the other cars stay in their lane and you let us stay in our lane. And for that, we say thank you. God, you got us to this place called Tristone. And as we're sitting in our homes, God, we just come to say thank you. I recognize that there's a lot of stuff going on in the world, God. And the enemy's trying to distract us. But God, we know that you still sit high and you look low. And the last time I checked, you were still sitting on the throne. And so God, as we pray for our world's condition, and as we lift up our president and our political parties, God, we lift up our first responders and our doctors and our nurses, and we lift up all the attendants that are assisting at this time. God, keep them covered in your blood. Watch over them. Keep them safe. Keep their families safe. God, I know sometimes we don't know what to do, but you left some mandates for us, God. You told us that, lo, I'm with you always, even until the end of the world. You told us that no weapons that's formed against us don't prosper. You told us that great you are and greatly to be praised. You said the cattle on a thousand hills belong to you. So God, we just come to say thank you. You told us that we could come bold to your throne for such a time as this. So God, here we are, standing on your word, standing on your promises, standing on your precepts, standing on your commandments, standing on your statutes, God, standing on your laws. We don't have nobody else to call on, but we call on you. And you told us that we could, so God, it's not my mother nor my father, nor my sister nor my brother, oh Lord, but it's me standing in the need of prayer. I lift Tristone up to you this morning. I lift Pastor Tucker and Lady Tucker up to you on this morning. I lift Bishop Ross and Lady Ross up to you this morning. Put your arms around them, God. Keep them covered in your blood. When it seems like their work is in vain, God, I need you to remind them that only what they do for you is going to last. So, God, there's the woman standing in the pulpit on today. Elder Janet Kimball Smith, God, stand up in her today. Touch her from the crown of her head down to the soles of her feet, God. I know she studied, I know she prepared, but if the anointing don't show up, God, give it to her now in the name of Jesus. Reveal hidden truths to your people, God. You said, ye that have an ear, let us hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. Stand up in her, God. Give her strength. Give her the anointing. Don't let her fear faces. Don't let her be anxious. But keep her covered in your blood. And God, we gonna give you a thank you and a hallelujah. We gonna tell somebody that you're a great God, that you're a holy God. And so God, we just say,
Oh,
others thou art calling. Do not pass me by. It's preaching time. It is time for the word. The Bible says that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. And we have one coming that can preach. And so I introduce to some and present to others none other than our executive pastor, Elder Janet Kimball Smith. Hear ye her now. Thank you.
Lift our power.
Come on, let's give God some praise. We owe him. We owe him. Lord, this is our praise. We owe it all to you. Yes. 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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Wherever you are, you can worship him. We owe him. God, we give you our praise in the name of Jesus. In the midst of, he's still good. In the midst of it all, he's still God. He's still sitting on the throne. He still has control. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. 87 years in this place. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Well, wherever you are, streaming with us, it's a good time right now. If you're happy and you know it, somebody ought to clap their hands. Clap your hands in your living room, wherever you are, in the sanctuary. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands in this place. Got a right, and you ought to give God a praise. Hallelujah. Amen. To God be the glory for the things that he has done. Amen. We're here today. We're celebrating our 87th year church anniversary. 87 years. It's amazing. Hallelujah.
And I'm glad to be in the service one more time. Amen. Amen. To my pastor, Pastor Del D. Tucker Sr., and First Lady Tammy Tucker, God bless you. To those that are here in the sanctuary that continue to assist us on Sundays to get God's word out to his people. Amen. To my friend, Elder Darden, who presided with us this morning. Those that are streaming, we thank God for you. Let's hear what the Lord has to say. Amen. If you would go with me to 1 Samuel chapter 30. 1 Samuel chapter 30. I'll be reading two verses, verse 6 and verse 8. 1 Samuel chapter 30, verse 6 and verse 8. And it reads, "And David was greatly distressed, for the people spake of stoning him, because the soul of all the people was grieved, every man for his sons and his daughters. But David encouraged himself in the Lord his God." Verse 8, "And David inquired at the Lord, saying, Shall I pursue after this troop? Shall I overtake them? And he answered him, Pursue, for thou shalt surely overtake them, and without fail recover all." Come on, somebody. Just for a few moments, I want to tell you and talk about how to encourage yourself and recover. How to encourage yourself and recover. Let us pray. Our Father and our God, we thank you once again, God, for this time and for this opportunity, God. God, I'm just a vessel. I can do anything without you. And now, God, I pray, oh God, that you would take this, your servant. God, I can't speak unless you speak for me. I can't hear from you, God, unless you speak through my ears, God. In the name of Jesus, we thank you for your word. We thank you for your word, and we stand on your promises. Now bless your word in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. God, I thank you for trusting me with your word and with your people. How to encourage yourself and recover. Amen. Listen here. In order to understand what caused David so much pain, sorrow, and anxiety in chapter 30, verse 6, we have to go back to chapter 29, where David was first rejected. I'm sure there has been times in your life that you've experienced rejection. I've experienced rejection. In ministry, you can experience rejection. We are here today celebrating 87 years as a church. And I know that the great men of God on whose shoulders we now stand experience some rejection down through the years. Even on your job and in your home, you can experience rejection. When you have done everything you are supposed to do, when you've been loyal and faithful, you can still encounter rejection. In the 29th chapter, David and his men is prepared to go and fight the enemy. The prince of the Philistines confronts Achish and asks, "Why are these Hebrews here? Why is David and his men here? They're not going to fight with us." Now, you would think if you were about to be in a fight and help shows up, you would welcome the help. But I believe that the Philistine ruler was just a little jealous or intimidated by David, because he says, what if he turns on us? He says, isn't this the same David that they were dancing and singing about, talking about Saul killed thousands and David 10,000s. I don't want him. I don't need him to fight with us. And he tells Achish, he said, send them away. Let me say, be careful about sending away your blessing. Achish tells David, he says, look, I'm sorry. I know you've been good. You've been consistent. I have not had any evil in you from day one, but you and your men can't go and fight with us. David pleads his case. He says, what have I done? You know I've been faithful and true. I've stood by you, but it does no good. And David tells his men, we can't go. We have to go back. The next day, David and his men make the three-day journey back to Ziklag. Chapter 30, when they get back to Ziklag, they find the Amalekites had taken their wives and their children and burned down their land. Listen, verse 2 says, they took them all, but they didn't kill anybody. I don't care what the devil throws at you. I don't care if he kidnaps your children. I don't care if he kidnaps your mind. I don't care if he takes everything you have. He has to leave you alive until God says different. In other words, you will live through this captivity. Somebody ought to say something right there. And here they are standing in the middle of the land and everything is gone. The Bible says that they cried until they had no more tears to cry. To make matters worse, the men that were with David just a few days ago that was ready to fight with him now turned on him. Oh, we all know somebody like that. Some people like that. The ones who said, I'll be there with you, but you can't find them when you really need them. The ones you confide in only to hear what you shared in confidence because you thought you could trust them. The ones who said, we got your back. The ones who said, we're going to be with you. The ones who said, don't worry about nothing. And now all of a sudden they can't be found. Those same men who were with him just a few days ago were now ready to kill David because to them it was David's fault that everything was gone. Remember, these same men were supposed to be his familiar friends, the ones in whom he trusted, who he sheltered, the ones who ate bread with him. And instead of having a little sympathy for him and offering him some relief, they turned on him. I can imagine them saying, David, if we would not have followed you, if we would have stayed here, this would not have happened. David feels bad enough. His wives are gone too. He lost everything too. And the Bible says he was greatly distressed because they turned on him. But David encouraged himself. He strengthened himself. So how did David encourage himself? He remembered God's past deliverances. You need some encouragement about what you've been going through. You got to think about how God has brought you out before, what he's already done in the past. See, those men gave liberty to their passion, but David set his graces to work. Those men dispirited each other, but David kept his spirit calm while he believed and considered the power of God. David's faith, get this, supplied him with the resources he needed. Your faith can supply you with what you need. I said your faith can supply you with what you need. I need somebody that's watching to know that when everything seems wrong, when it looks bad, when folk turn on you, you've got to encourage yourself. But David encouraged himself. That word but is a conjunction. That means two things are happening at the same time. We quarantine in our house, but most of us haven't missed a meal. Two things happening at the same time. We in the midst of this virus, but God is keeping us. Two things happening at the same time. You can be sick, but healing taking place. Two things happening at the same time. Crying tears, but have joy. Two things happening at the same time. Let me tell you how we can encourage and strengthen ourselves. David consulted with the Lord, and he didn't just encourage himself, but he encouraged himself in the Lord his God. He knew and believed that God could fix it. I need somebody else that's watching to know that God can fix it. I don't care what your it is, what your it consists of, but God can fix it. When God is in control, that's all the encouragement that you need. But how do we encourage ourselves. We encourage ourselves through the word. Proverbs 3:5. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. Encourage yourself in the word. Isaiah 41:10. Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed. I am your God. I will strengthen you. You've got to encourage yourself in the word. Jeremiah 33:3. Call unto me, and I will answer thee. Encourage yourself in the word. Galatians 6:9. And be not weary in well doing. In due season, we will reap if we faint not. Encourage yourself in the word. Philippians 1:6. Being confident of this very thing, he that began a good work in you will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. You can encourage yourself. Just look in the word. Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. Well, after David started talking to himself, he got some strength. See, it's all right to talk to yourself sometime. I said it's all right to talk to yourself sometime. When nobody else is there to encourage you, you've got to encourage yourself. Encourage yourself and say, self, we're going to make it. Self, it's going to be all right. Self, we're coming out of this thing. Self, we healed. Self, we got this. See, David got his strength. And after he got done talking to himself, in chapter 30, verse 8, he started talking to the Lord. But before he asked God anything, he asked the priest to bring him the ephod. Pastor, I missed this the first time, but I realized and I looked up, and the ephod was a priestly garment often used to inquire of God to determine his will in any given situation. See, when he was rejected early on, he didn't ask God if he should go, but now he was prepared, and he prepared himself before he went to the Lord. He had too much at stake. His wives was at stake. Those children were at stake. The livelihood was at stake. He had to make sure he was hearing from God. We need to prepare ourselves to go to God. We need to prepare our mind, our thoughts, and our hearts. He prepared himself, and then he said, Lord, shall I pursue after this troop? Should I go get them? Should I overtake them? Should I go get my stuff back? And God said, go. But then this is what he said. Not only will you overtake them, and not only will you overtake them without fail, but everything they took, everything they got, your wives and your children, you shall recover it all. David got a little happy, and he started gathering all the men. Not all of them could make it across the brook. Now, this is just me. Probably the ones that turned on him was the ones that really couldn't make it. But they came across one of the men that was with the army that came and kidnapped their family. He came across one of the men that had been with the Egyptian army. He was a part of the kidnapping. He was a part of burning down the land. His army had left him because he got sick. See, his own people turned on him when he got sick and couldn't make it. Mama used to say, get sick, but don't stay sick too long, because folk will leave you and folk will forget about you. But look how God set this thing up. He will allow those that try to destroy you be the ones that lead you to your blessing, the ones that give you your victory. He showed David where they were, and here they are. They celebrating everything that they took. They eating, they dancing, they drinking, and they having a good time. And the Bible said that David attacked them all night and all day, and he recovered everything the enemy had taken from them, and nothing was lacked. I said nothing was lacked. Nothing small, nothing big, not their sons, not their daughters, nothing spoiled. David recovered it all, but because David recovered it all, because
because David encouraged himself in the Lord, it was easy for him to write in Psalms, "Oh Lord, our Lord, how excellent is thy name," in the Psalms. He looked back and remembered, "The Lord is my rock and my fortress and my deliverer." He said, "Some trust in chariots and some in horses, but we will remember the name of the Lord our God. We can't forget, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want." What about lift up your head, O ye gates, and be lifted up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is the King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty. We've got to encourage ourselves like David. He said, "When they're wicked, even mine enemies and my foes came upon me to eat up my flesh, what happened to them? They stumbled and they fell." I'm just trying to tell somebody streaming with us, when you encourage yourself, you shall recover. 87 years, Tristone, from 1933, Reverend P.J. Fisher to Reverend Robinson to the Honorable Jerome Bishop Ross to Overseer Dale D. Tucker Sr. We will recover, because God said, "Upon this rock I'll build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail." Get ready, get ready, get ready to recover everything the enemy stole from you. Encourage yourself and recover your mind. Encourage yourself and recover your strength. Encourage yourself and recover your health. Encourage yourself and recover your job. Encourage yourself and recover your children. Encourage yourself and recover your money. Encourage yourself and recover your power. Christ on, we will recover. Pastor, you will recover. Bishop, you will recover. Saints of God, we will recover. Country shut down, but we shall recover. I don't know when, but I know how. I don't know when, but I know who. I don't know when, but I know who. I don't know when, but I know who. God, 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 that's who. Jesus, Waymaker, Jesus, Lily of the Valley, Jesus, Healer, Jesus, Strength, Jesus, Deliverer. Encourage yourself, encourage yourself, and recover. You shall recover it all. Everything the enemy stole, everything you're looking for, everything, you're gonna get it back. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Encourage yourself and recover through the word of God. God bless you.
Come on, somebody, let's give God some praise. Come on, somebody ought to give God praise. If there's anybody out there that knows what it is to have some things taken away, today, the word for you today is that you shall recover all. Somebody ought to give God praise that all that you lost, God's going to bring back to you. Hallelujah. To help me celebrate our executive pastor, Elder Janet Kimball Smith, for that mighty word on today. And before we move any further, can you help me give God one more praise for blessing this place called Tristone? 87 years, God has been good to us. God has been good to you. Come on, wherever you are, let's just begin to give God a thank you Thank you for all that you have done. Thank you for what you're doing right now. But God, we say thank you most of all for where you're taking us and recovering all back to us. We are certainly grateful for all that we have experienced on today. We've read scripture, we've prayed, we've given God praise through the fruit of our lips and song. But I believe that God wants to continue to grow his church. The scripture even tells us that the gates of hell might even rise up, but it won't prevail. Which means if you can but believe God, God knows how to keep his church and keep his people. So we extend to somebody on today that may be streaming with us now an opportunity to get to know the Lord Jesus Christ for yourself. What an encouraging word on today to know that God knows how to orchestrate things and put you back in position and allow you to walk in the newness of life. We encourage you today that if you don't know Christ, that you would accept him on today. If you can yet confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. We offer you Christ today. We want you to be a part of God's church, a part of the kingdom. Let's pray. God, we say thank you. We're grateful for who you are. We thank you for your word that you have brought to us on today. God, when we can't find encouragement, it's good to know that we can encourage ourselves. We're not just encourage ourselves.